Hi, in this video I want to show you 11 Mac apps that I use and you should definitely try. I didn't include apps that everyone knows like Notion, Slack, Photoshop, Premiere Pro and stuff. I found more niche and useful apps. Some of these apps are free, some of them are paid. I will talk about them all, but one of the apps that I will talk in this video is very, very effective and affects all the other apps. The first app I want to talk about is Downy. Downy helps you download videos from all over the internet. For example, like when you want to download a video from YouTube, you go, you get the URL and then you go to Google and search for like YouTube video download or something, and you download it from a very safe, I bet no virus looking website. Well, you don't have to do that anymore with Downy. When you paste the link of the video or music here, you can download it in any format you want up to 4K. Whether you download a video from YouTube, from Instagram, from X, it doesn't matter, you can download it. You can download videos, you can download music, etc. However, Downy is a paid app. It has a one-time fee of $20, but if you're a student, you can get a 30% discount. But as I said at the beginning of the video, one of the apps that I will talk about will affect all the other apps in terms of price. But you know, I'm a content creator as well, so like, I'm not gonna mention it at the beginning of the video, so keep watching. Like, that's rule number one. If you create content, you know. Secondly, there is the Hand Mirror. Hand Mirror is a free app, and what it does is that when you download the app, an icon like this appears here on the menu bar, and when you click it, you see yourself. As you can understand from the name, Hand Mirror, it works as a mirror. You can change your camera from here, like if I choose my studio display camera, you can see. And you can use that, you know, to check yourself, like before you go to a meeting, like how do I look? Am I in the middle? What else is seen in the background? Like, can they see like my bed or something, you know? And on the paid plan, it also has a paid plan. You can see your microphone, like you can check your microphone, like if there is audio, like if you, they can hear you, and you can change that from here as well. Like right now, the MacBook Pro microphone is selected, so like my MacBook Pro microphone works just fine. Like it, you know, gets my audio, my voice. Now, if you think about it, you can do the same thing from photo booth, but this is like just one click away, and it's a bit faster, and it's a free app. Like you don't have to pay, like just to see your microphone if it's working or not. So if you're gonna use the free version, like that's just easier. I mean, I use it. Thirdly, there is App Cleaner. When you delete an app on your Mac, it's not fully deleted. It always leaves some files behind. App Cleaner, on the other hand, deletes all these unnecessary files when you delete, you know, the app. You drag the app you want to delete here, and App Cleaner finds all the files of this app on our computer and offers us the option to delete them as well. I think that's pretty good. In fact, if you turn on the smart delete feature, even if you delete apps normally like you always do by dragging them to the trash bin, this app will detect that and find you the unnecessary files to be deleted. Also, it's a free app, they offer it for free. You can, if you want, donate to them like from their website. Our fourth app, NotchNook. Now, when I say NotchNook, I also mean Alcove and Boring Notch. Like, think about as if I'm talking for all three of these apps. Alcove and NotchNook are paid and Boring Notch is free. But the logic of all of them is the same. I mean, I also made an Instagram Reels video about this, so if you don't follow me on Instagram, go and drop a follow. This app makes this notch of your MacBook dynamic just like on iPhones. From here, you can stop the music, change the music, check your calendar. You can also like airdrop files or move files in bulk. I actively use NotchNook. I think like the animations are just, you know, better and like smoother. But in terms of features, like even if you go with Boring Notch, which is free, like they offer the same features. I just found NotchNook to be like a little bit smoother. And I mean, honestly, I really like how this looks. Like Apple should add this feature, not an app. The fifth program, Dropover. This program actually offers a feature previous app offers, the moving files in bulk. When you hold the file and shake it like this, this will pop up. You can drop as many files as you want into this area and then move them all in bulk to wherever you want. This is also a paid app, but it also has a free version. The only downside is that the free version has a 3-second waiting time. I mean, to be honest, like 3 seconds is nothing. Like if I was to go through all these files one by one, dragging and dropping files, it would take me longer. So like, I'll just wait 3 seconds. Like, why not? I think it's very useful. I wanted to add this to the list because some people might not want to have a notch, a dynamic notch on their Macs, but they might want that feature, like transferring files in bulk. So like, I just want to add it to the list. Sixth, I want to give a place to Cleanshot X. This app is a screenshot app. It helps you take much more beautiful and aesthetic looking screenshots. And I love it. Let me show you how it works. When you download the app, an icon like this comes to the menu bar on the top right. And from here, you can see all the screenshot features that this app has. It also has a record screen feature, like you can screen record your desktop. But my favorite is capture window. Like when you click on that, it automatically detects windows. And when you click on a window, it takes the screenshot. Let's click save. If we check the screenshot, you can see it adds this padding effect on the screenshot. And that looks pretty cool in my opinion. And it's not capturing this area. Like it doesn't matter if you have files, images, folders on your desktop, it will not capture that. It adds that on top of that. Like if Even if we had like a full screen, I can click capture window again, let's save it, and again it adds that effect. And that looks pretty aesthetic in my opinion. And you can change that from the settings, like if you don't like that, you can come to the settings. You can choose it like from the wallpaper settings, you can choose it as like to use your desktop wallpaper, or you can choose a custom wallpaper, a custom image, or you can use a plain color, or if you don't want that effect, you can see transparent and it will only capture like the window. And you can also like adjust the padding, you can choose capture window shadows, like the shadows of the windows, but I'm not gonna go into the details. Another cool feature that I like is the scrolling capture. Like for example, if I'm gonna capture a screenshot of my YouTube videos, I can click scrolling capture, choose the area that I'm gonna scroll, like for example here, then I click start capture, I click auto scroll, and when I keep my mouse at the bottom it will scroll automatically. I don't have any other videos, I click done, and this is the screenshot. Like that's also pretty useful. You can do that in many websites, like you can take bigger screenshot, for example if you're gonna take a screenshot of an article, you can take that in one screenshot. Or one more feature that I want to show you is the capture text. Like I can choose an area on my screen or on an image like this, and it will capture all the text that you select. Basically, let me open a notepad, and when I paste here, it copied everything that I just selected, and that might be useful for some people. As I said, it's a very nice app, I use it, I love it, but it is a paid app. It has a one-time fee of $29 or $8 per month. However, if it seems expensive, don't worry, just take a look at the app that I'm about to show you. The seventh app is Setup, the app that I mentioned at the beginning of the video, the app that affects all the other apps. This app is kind of like the Netflix of apps, or like App Store of apps. Setup has a monthly fee of $10 or $9 if you like pay annually, and you can use a ton of paid apps in this app without paying extra money. For example, the screenshot app that I showed you just now, like the CleanShot X or Downy or Hand Mirror, it has a paid plan. You can download the paid plan from there. You get all these apps by paying a monthly fee just to set up, which is $10 or $9. I think it's pretty cool, and it's not too expensive in my opinion, like considering how much you get. If you were to go and like pay individually for all these apps, you would spend a fortune. But you just pay $10 and get access to all of these. Like that's what I do. All the paid apps that I have on my Mac are from Setup. I think it makes a lot of sense. Numero 8. Supercharge. In short, this app offers you a lot of shortcuts. For example, the one that I use the most is like when you open a page or an app, to minimize it, you go back here from the top left and you minimize it. But what I can do with Supercharge is that I can open it like this and close it like this. Like I just click again on the icon and it minimizes. I think that's pretty cool. Like if I want to check something, like I can just do that, check it, and then close it. Or normally when you want to delete something on Macs, you have to do command and delete to delete something. You can now add that to only delete, like you can, when you click delete, it deletes. Or the clock app normally does not show the seconds when it's in the dark, but when you open this setting from here, you also see the seconds. Yeah, I know, don't get too excited. I know it's like a mind-blowing feature, but don't get too excited, okay? Okay. I know, like, that's like, kind of silly, but you know, that's like an option. If you want, you can do that. You never know what you can do. 2025, like, the possibilities are endless. But basically, you can assign shortcuts to many things. Like, you can add a shortcut to switch to dark mode, turning on low battery mode, opening Finder, minimizing windows, all windows altogether, like, or quitting all windows or all apps altogether, clearing notifications, clearing the trash bin, and many other features. So like, yeah, it's not a mind-blowing app, but it allows you to add shortcuts to many things that you do daily, basically, tasks that you do daily, and that can make your life easier and faster. This is also a paid app, by the way. It costs $14, a one-time fee. Or if you use Setup, you can just download it from there. Ninth app is Raycast. This app is a Spotlight alternative, but with more features. Okay, yeah, I can access files with Spotlight as well, but Raycast just offers so many more features. For example, I can quickly locate windows or apps on my screen like this. Like I can just say left, I can say right, I can say center. Like you can have a window like this and you just want to center it, like, you know, center. You can say center and it centered, like. Or if you have smart lights, you can control them from here. I won't list all the features here, but as you can see, it is possible to do a lot of commands. Now, there is a paid version of this app, but I use the free one. On the paid one, it also offers you, like, translate and AI and stuff, but, like, I just didn't want to pay for that. I think I can do all that with, like, from the browser. So, like, I didn't want to pay for something like this. I didn't find it worth it. I mean, it might have more features that I didn't see, but I just used the free version. 10th app, Arc. Arc is a browser. The browser that I use for like for a while now. It's not a very well-known browser. I also saw it from another creator and I really like the design. While the tabs are on the top in many browsers, they are on the left in arc. Like the screens are already wider laterally, like, so you don't have so much vertical space. And if you add tabs on top of that, you just have less vertical space. So it's smarter to have them on the side. There are other browsers that do that as well. I'm not saying Arc is the only one, but I just like the Arc in general because it's not just about the UI design. Like that's the biggest factor for me, but it's not the only thing. For example, when you want to work on two tabs at the same time, all you have to do is hold one tab and drag it next to the other one, two tabs side by side. Or when I click on a link with the little tabs feature by pressing the shift key, a small preview tab like this opens, I can look at the page from there, and when I close it, I can continue where I left off on the previous page. I think Arc is a great browser, you should give it a try. And finally, Ina. Even if it wasn't, it is now. Ina is a media player, and at first glance, you might say, that's QuickTime Player. Because it looks exactly like the same, but it's not, it offers much more. Let's open a video for example, it looks the same, but if you click on three dots here, you can see it offers so much more, like you can change the aspect ratio, you can change the crop of the video, you can rotate the video, you can change the speed of the video. That's something that you have on QuickTime as well, but like here you can speed the video so much more, you can toggle on and off the HDR of the video, you can adjust the brightness, the contrast, the saturation of the video and everything like that. When we come to the audio, you can see you can add a delay and there's also equalizer so you can adjust the audio as well, and there are also subtitles, like you can add subtitles. Like that's pretty good, but is that all? Nah. When you open Ina, you can also open a video with URL, like you can paste the URL here and you can watch the video here. For example, a YouTube video, you can watch the YouTube video here on the media player. Like why would someone do that? Well, like you can adjust the image settings, like the brightness and stuff, you can adjust the audio, the equalizer, and there are just more speed options. Like someone might not, like 2x might not be enough for some people, I don't know, like you never know, someone might, you know, need it. This is also a free app, you can just download and use it. By the way, the names and links of all these apps are in the description below, you can check them out. And if you enjoyed the video, you can subscribe and like the video for more content like this, and see you in the next one.